Good morning to all. On today's session, so I will explain about the maximum blade efficiency derivation for multi-stage impulse turbine. So this multi-stage impulse turbine, also called as Curtis stage turbine. So this type of the impulse turbine consists of two or more number of stages in order to get the maximum efficiency from the turbines. The Curtis stage turbine or Curtis turbine is also called as velocity compounded axial flow impulse turbine. See the velocity diagram here. See, initially fluid is get exited from the nozzle here, nozzle. So that velocity is called as absolute velocity of the fluid at inlet, and corresponding angle of that velocity, that is a nozzle angle, is taken as a alpha 1. So then fluid is flowing through the moving blades, and the relative velocity of the moving blade at inlet is given as a VR1, and relative velocity of the fluid at exit is termed as a VR2, and corresponding blade angles at inlet as well as exit are beta 1 and beta 2. So this nozzle and moving blade comprises of first stage. The fluid is get exited from the first stage at the absolute velocity of V2, and corresponding angle of that absolute velocity is termed as alpha 2. So then that exit of the fluid exit from the moving blade, that is a inlet for to the fixed blades. So in between these two moving blades, there is one fixed blade. So now fluid from the first moving blade, then it's flowing through the fixed blade between these two moving blades. The absolute velocity of V2 at inlet and corresponding angle is alpha 2 for the fixed blade. So then from the fixed blade, the fluid is flowing through that one, and finally it is get exited here at the velocity of V3, and corresponding angle of that fixed blade is alpha 3. So that is the absolute velocity at inlet for the second stage. So this V3 represents absolute velocity of fluid for the second stage. So next, from the fixed blade, the fluid is flowing through this moving, the second set of the moving blade, and the relative velocity at inlet as well as relative velocity at exit of the moving blade is termed as VR3 and VR4. The blade angles of the second stage moving blade are beta 3 as well as beta 4. And finally, fluid is get exited from the second stage or second set of the moving blade at the absolute velocity of V4, and that angle of that fixed blade is taken as alpha 4. So now here the nozzle and first set of the moving blade comprises of the first stage, and fixed blade and the moving blade of the second set is termed as a second stage. So now this figure shows that there are two stages here. The corresponding to this arrangement, the velocity diagram is shown over here. The velocity for the first stage, another one is a velocity triangle for the second stage. See this velocity diagram. So there is a V1, the absolute velocity of the fluid at inlet, and relative velocity of the fluid at inlet for the first stage is VR1. And corresponding angle for the absolute velocity is alpha 1, and corresponding angle for the relative velocity at inlet is beta 1. So then The relative velocity of the fluid at exit is taken as a beta VR2 and corresponding angle is taken as a beta 2. Absolute velocity of the fluid at exit of the first stage is V2 and corresponding angle is alpha 2. And VA, V of A1 and V of A2 represents the flow velocity at inlet as well as the flow velocity at exit of the first stage. So next, see the distance of tangential velocity at inlet, that is termed as VU1, and tangential velocity of the fluid at exit is taken as VU2, and total this distance is represented as delta VU, the delta VU for the first stage. This is the tangential velocity for the first stage. Next, here x1 distance is mentioned and distance of x2 is mentioned here. And coming to the second stage velocity triangle, so here v3 represents absolute velocity of the fluid at inlet and corresponding that fixed blade angle is taken as alpha 3. The relative velocity of the fluid at inlet of the second stage is termed as vr3 and blade angle at the inlet is beta 3. Similarly, the blade velocity at exit is termed beta 4 and the relative velocity of the fluid at exit of the second stage is VR 4. Absolute velocity of the fluid at exit of the second stage is V 4 and their fixed blade angle, the fixed blade angle is alpha 4. So here V of A 3 and V of A 4 termed as flow velocity at inlet of the second stage and VR4 flow velocity at exit of the second stage. Then tangential velocity at inlet velocity triangle is termed as VU3 and VU4 represents tangential velocity at exit and the total distance is taken as delta VU2. So for the first stage, the tangential velocity, the change in tangential velocity is termed as delta VU, and in second stage the tangential velocity is termed total change in tangential velocity termed as delta VU2. So once again here some distance is mentioned as x3 as well as x4. Now consider this inlet velocity triangle. So what about this distance of x1? So what about the distance of this x1? So if you take the trigonometric relations cos beta 1, so at that time the cos is the ratio of the adjacent by hypotenuse, the adjacent side is what, x1, and hypotenuse is taken as a vr1. So now I want to take the distance of x1. So according to that, the x1 is equals to vr1 cos beta 1, vr1 cos beta 1. So similarly for x2 distance, the x2 is here, and if you take cos beta 2, if you take the cos beta 2, so at that time it is a ratio of what, x2 by vr2, correct, x2 by vr2. That means the distance of x2 is equals to vr2 cos beta 2, vr2 cos beta 2. The one more trigonometric relations taken in this velocity triangle, in the inlet velocity first stage velocity triangle. So what about the distance of VU1? What is the distance of VU1? So now you consider, so this alpha 1 or alpha angle, so now cos alpha 1 is equals to, the cos alpha 1 is equals to at that time the ratio of VU1 by V1, right? So VU1, the adjacent side, and hypotenuse is taken as V1. So for that reason, the distance of VU1 is equals to V1 cos alpha 1, V1 cos alpha 1. So similarly for VU2, so what about now VU2? If you take cos alpha 2, if you take cos alpha 2, so at that time it is a ratio of VU2 by V2, VU2 by V2. So now I want the distance of VU2, that means V2 cos alpha 2. That means the distance of VU2 is equals to V2 cos alpha 2. Next, one more relations are considered here. See, in case now I want to measure the distance of x1. Now I want to take the distance of x1. The x1 is equals to what? At that, if the total distance, this total distance is taken as vu1, vu1, and this distance is taken as u. If you subtract this u from the vu1, so now you are getting the distance of x1. That means the x1 is equals to vu1 minus u. Similarly, x2 is equals to, so what about this x2? The x2 is equals to vu2, the distance of vu2 plus blade velocity u. There is one more relation is considered here. X2 is equals to vu2 plus distance of u. Now coming to the exit velocity triangle, coming to the exit velocity, the second stage velocity diagram. So here x3 distance is mentioned. X3. So what about x3? If you take cos beta 3, so at that time this distance x3 is equals to vr3 cos beta 3. Similarly, x4 distance is considered. X4 is equals to, at that time, cos beta 4 is equals to x4 by vr4. That means x4 distance is equals to vr4 cos beta 4. Also, what about this distance of vu3? Cos alpha 3 is equals to distance of vu3 by v3. That means vu3, a tangential velocity at inlet of the second stage, is equals to v3 cos alpha 3. Also, vu4 is equals to v4 cos alpha 4. Next, distance of x3 is also measured by these two values, vu3 as well as uu. That means x3 is equals to vu3 minus u. Similarly, x4 is equals to vu4 plus u. So these are the some trigonometric relations are considered while deriving the expression for Curtis stage. The velocity diagrams for first and second stage of a Curtis turbine, velocity compounded impulse turbine, are shown in figure. The tangential speed of blade for both the rows is same since all the moving blades are mounted on the same shaft. So here both set of the moving blades are connected to a same shaft. For that reason, the tangential blade speed, that is u, remains constant for both these two stages. Assume equiangular stator and rotor blades. So one more assumption is made here. The stator and rotor blades are equiangular, and blade velocity coefficient, that is C of B for stator and rotor blades are same. That means C of B is equals to blade velocity coefficient is equals to VR2 by VR1 for first stage. For the second stage, C of B is equals to VR4 by VR3. The work done by the first row of moving blade is, that is termed as W1. The W1 represents work done in first stage is equals to U into delta VU1 is equals to U into VU1 plus VU2. That is the tangential velocity at inlet as well as tangential velocity at exit of the first stage. So that represents what? Delta VU. This is a change in tangential velocity in first stage of the moving blades. From first stage velocity diagram, VU1 is equals to V1 cos alpha 1. So already I told some trigonometric relations in that both velocity triangles. So here the distance of VU of U1 is equals to V1 cos alpha 1, and also VU2 is equals to x2 minus u. So that VU2 distance is measured as x2 minus u. So what about x2 here? The x2 is a relation of, according to trigonometric relations, the x2 distance is equals to VR2 cos beta 2 minus u. Now VU2 is equals to, see here, according to the blade velocity coefficient is a ratio of VR2 by VR1. So what about VR2 now? The VR2 is equals to C of B into VR1. So for that reason, say instead of VR2 in that previous expression, in this one VU2 is taken as C of B into VR1. That represents the distance of VR2 value into cos beta 1. So because of this equiangular blades, the rotor blades, beta 1 is equals to beta 2. For that reason, the cos beta 2 is taken as cos beta 1 minus u. So because beta 1 is equals to beta 2 and VR2 is equals to C of B into VR1 according to blade velocity coefficient. So VU2, now VU2 is equals to C of B, C of B. See here in this expression VR1 cos beta 1. So here VR1 cos beta 1 is equals to X1. So according to trigonometric relations from that velocity triangles, VR1 cos beta 1 is equals to X1, then minus U is equals to C of B. The X1 can also written, you can write this x1 distance is equals to VU1 minus U. Then one more U is here and that is minus U. So this is simplification of this expression, VU2 expression. This VU2 expression is represented as VU2 is equals to C of B into VU1 minus U into minus U. Because VR1 cos beta 1 is equals to X1, so that is equals to VU1 minus U. So according to that, V of U2 is equals to CB. So once again, here V1 cos, so here VU1 is equals to what? VU1 is equals to, VU1 is equals to V1 cos alpha 1. Substitute that. Instead of this VU1 is equals to V1 cos alpha 1 minus U into minus U. Because VU1 is equals to V1 cos alpha 1. So now then W1, that is a work done in first stage, is equals to U into VU1 cos alpha 1 plus C of B into V1 cos alpha 1 minus U minus U. You can simplify this one. U multiply this here inside V1 cos alpha 1 plus C of B, that is once again U is here. Just multiplied and simplification by the simplification, C of B U into V of 1 cos alpha 1 minus C of B, and once again U is here, that is U square minus U square. So now work done in first stage is equals to 1 plus C of B into U V1 cos alpha 1 minus into 1 plus C of B into U square. After simplification of that, work done in first stage is equals to 1 plus C of B into U V1 cos alpha 1 minus U square. Similarly, work done by the second stage. So that second stage work done is represented by W2 is equals to 1 plus C of B into U V3 cos alpha 3 minus U square. So this expression is obtained similarly from the first stage expression. For first stage of for first stage work done is given by W1 is equals to 1 plus C of V U V1 cos alpha 1 minus U square. So similarly in second stage the work done is equals to 1 plus C of B and U instead of V1 it is taken as a V3 and here cos alpha 1 is there and here it is taken as a cos alpha 3. Now W2, the work done in second stage is equals to 1 plus C of B, then CB U V2 cos alpha 2 minus U square, because alpha 3 is equals to alpha 2 and V3 is equals to C of B V2 from the relation blade velocity coefficient. Now work done at second stage is equals to 1 plus C of B into CB U into VU2 minus U square, because V2 cos alpha 2 is equals to VU2. Now this work done expression, the work done expression for second stage W2 is equals to 1 plus C of B into C of B U into C of B into V1 cos alpha 1 minus U into minus U into minus U square. So because VU2 is equals to C of B V1 cos alpha 1 minus U into minus U, and the V2 expression becomes now 1 plus C of B CB square U into V1 cos alpha 1 minus CB square U square minus CB of C of B U square minus U square. Finally, W2 work done in second stage is equals to 1 plus C of B CB C of B square U into V1 cos alpha 1 minus U square into 1 plus C of B plus C of B square. The total work done by the Curtis stage is given by total work done W of T is equals to work done on first stage and work done in second stage. So according to this expression, the work done for first stage and the second stage is substituted in this total work done expression. After simplification of this one, so here take one more expression as the C of B dash is equals to 1 plus C of B into 1 plus C of B square and C of B double dash is equals to 1 plus C of B into 2 plus C of B plus C of B square. So according to this, say the total work done is equals to C of B dash U into V1 cos alpha 1 minus C of B double dash U square. Now so that is expression for the total work done in a multi-stage turbine. Now coming to the blade or rotor efficiency. Is given by, that is neta B, blade efficiency is equals to the ratio of total work done to the energy available at the inlet, or energy transfer. Correct, energy transfer, the work done, total work done in a two stages are given by C of B dash U into V1 cos alpha 1 minus C of B double dash U square, and energy available at the inlet of the rotor blade is given by half V1 square. So now here the 2 at the denominator is taken to numerator, at that time 2 into C of B and the U by V1, because at numerator C of B 1 dash U into V1 is there, denominator V1 square, the one V1 square get cancelled, the final you are getting U by V1 cos alpha 1 minus C of B double dash the U square by V1 square. Now blade efficiency is equals to 2 into C of B single dash, the U by V1 is equals to speed ratio is given by 5 into cos alpha 1 C of B double dash the U square by V1 square is equals to 5 square. So the blade efficiency is equals to 2 into C of B dash 5 cos alpha 1 minus C of B cos 5 square. The slope for maximum blade efficiency. So now I want to calculate what is the maximum blade efficiency in a Curtis stage turbine. So according to this slope, the maximum blade efficiency is calculated by differentiating of this blade efficiency with respect to phi, speed ratio is equals to 0. So now d by d of phi, that is a blade efficiency is derivation is obtained as 2 into c of b dash phi cos alpha 1 minus c of b double dash phi square is equals to 0. So now differentiate this expression with respect to speed ratio. So with respect to that, 2 into c of b single dash cos alpha 1 minus 2 c of b dash to the phi square is equals to 0. The maximum blade efficiency is equals to 2 into c of b single dash into c of b single dash by c of b double dash cos alpha 1 by 2 into cos alpha 1 minus c of b double dash into c of b single dash to the c of b double dash cos alpha 1 by 2 whole square. After simplification of this expression, the maximum blade efficiency is equals to c of b single dash square by c of b dash cos square alpha 1 by 2. In case if blade velocity coefficient c of b is equals to 1, so now c of b dash is equals to 4 and c of b dash double dash is equals to 8. For single stage impulse turbine, the work done is equals to 2 into u v1 cos alpha 1 minus u square, and optimum speed ratio is equals to cos alpha 1 by 2, and maximum blade efficiency is given by cos square alpha 1. For Curtis of two stage velocity compounded turbine, the total work done is given by 4 into u into v1 cos alpha 1 minus 2 u square. The optimum speed ratio is equals to cos alpha 1 by 4, and maximum blade efficiency in a Curtis stage or two stage velocity compounded turbine is given by cos square alpha 1. So these are the some important expressions used in a single stage impulse turbine as well as a two stage velocity compounded impulse turbine, and these are the expressions for work done, optimum speed ratio, as well as a maximum blade speed. Similarly for n stage Curtis, that means in case, so in this derivation we used only two stages. In case the turbines consist of more number of stages, the more than two stages, so at that time, so this the work done expression becomes 2 into n into u into v1 cos alpha 1 minus u square. So here n represents the number of stages. N represents number of stages included in a turbine assembly. In case the two stages are included at that time, the N is equals to 2. In case it consists of three stages, at that time N is equals to 3. And expression for optimum speed ratio is equals to cos alpha 1 by 2. Optimum speed ratio is cos alpha 1 by 2 n. So once again here also n represents number of stages. The maximum blade efficiency is equals to cos square alpha 1. So this expression remains as the same for both multi-stage impulse turbine as well as single stage impulse turbine. For all Curtis turbines, the maximum blade efficiency remains same irrespective of their number of stages. So there is a final conclusion from this derivation is that for all Curtis turbine, the maximum blade efficiency remains same irrespective of their number of stages. In this topic we discussed about, so what is expression for work done for the multi-stage turbine, and what is expression for the optimum speed ratio, as well as what is expression for the maximum blade efficiency of the multi-stage turbine. Thank you.